Wearing a hearing aid should not stop you from playing the sports that you like to play. However, you want to be careful playing high-impact sports though. You don't want to injure yourself. First, you don't want your hearing aids to come off if you play a high-impact sport like hockey, wrestling, even skydiving, for example, because if you drop that in the sky, I'm not quite sure you can pick it up after when it drops onto the ground. It's going to either hurt someone or it's going to be obliterated. Hello everyone, my name is Yat. I'm deaf without hearing aids. I'm hard of hearing with hearing aids. Today I'm stepping outside of my home for a little bit in my car about to go into a driving range. When you play high impact sports, you have to be careful not to knock off your hearing aids, or when they do come off, you want to be careful to not step on it or the other person stepping on it as well. I recall wrestling one time in high school. I wore my hearing aids, I even had my prosthetics on, and a guy came over and gave me a full Nelson, and as I was trying to pull away from the full Nelson, my ears came off and my hearing aids as well. I didn't know what to do at the time. I had zero self-confidence. I saw my ears and my hearing aid on the mat, and I literally just ran away from the troubles of my life. Obviously, troubles follow you, follow me, wherever we go, and we can't run away from them. But at that moment, my hearing aids and my ears, I literally ran away. So I don't encourage you to do that. I actually encourage you to actually take initiatives to protect yourself. And if there are situations where you can't play sports or particular sports, or you require accommodation, do ask for them. Do let people know. I find that once you start letting people know that you wear a hearing device or you wear a prosthetic ear, they do watch out for you. Also, you have to know about yourself as well. You want to know your conditions. You want to know your limit. Obviously, when we're training, when we do CrossFit or high functional training at the gym or wherever we go, we want to test ourselves to the limit. But hearing aids are electronics. They're prone to getting wet. They're prone to your sweat. When electronics get damped or wet or moist, they don't work well, and it requires you to put them in a rice bag or a dehumidifier. So it stops you from hearing. What I find helpful when I'm going to the gym is I take off my hearing aid. You know, it is silent. It is really quiet. But what I do appreciate is the bass from the music that is pounding from the speaker. I recognize it's only me and myself and my mental state. It helps me relax. It helps me work out. It helps me focus on my reps. It helps me focus on not trying to avoid getting wet or not trying to sweat, because as you're aware, sweating does help. So do sweat, but when you do, make sure you either have your hearing device off or you've known that your hearing device will not stop working when you sweat. In terms of playing sport, you want to, obviously, if you're playing high impact sport, you want to wear a clip so it doesn't pop off and then possibly hit the ground, and if there's other players running around, they might step on it, it might trip them, and you might even break them too. And you don't want to have a $5,000 hearing aid lying on the ground, potentially being stepped on and breaking. So you want to be careful of that. If you wear hearing aids or even wear prosthetics, let me know in the comment section below what sports you enjoy playing. Make sure to hit the like button, subscribe, and hit that bell icon so you can receive the latest videos from me. Until next time, goodbye!